Good morning. Welcome to all of you. Our bell ringer this morning didn't have the usual gusto. Yeah, felt like he was farther away than normal. But a good start for what we're doing here, to be gathered in the presence of God for worship and praise and thanksgiving and the blessing of God's gifts for us, for faithful living. So we will endeavor to take hold of all of that and join together in a true and genuine worship in the Holy Spirit. You can see, if you got a green sheet, that there are lots of things to attend to this morning with the bake sale for the LWML ladies, and those proceeds will go to missions. And a new website, the church website, has been redesigned. It's up and running now, so you can check that out. Maybe not right now. Hold off for an hour or so, which I think you'll really like it, and it'd be much more useful to each of us to stay connected to the church. You see, tomorrow of UR special outreach with a mobile birthday celebration with Faye Davis, and then Tuesday, the men and the women are meeting. The men take note of the time at 6 o'clock at Luby's over on 183. And then also the LWML is meeting that night, this Tuesday. What time, Betsy? 5:30 for the ladies right here at the church. Other announcements? We'll share the peace of Christ with each other. The peace of the Lord be with you. Praise and petitions. Dawn. Congratulations. Giving thanks. Passed the first two of four GED tests. So on our way. Keep studying hard. Pat. A neighbor up against pneumonia and other ailments, praying the Lord to give him strength for healing and recovery. Rocky?
Yeah,
asking God to work through the health care and give Rocky a road to recovery and strengthen you and your body. Suzanne.
Prayers for my sister-in-law, Vicki Oriak, who is having a real struggle with pain from spinal stenosis. And for my neighbor, Anita Williams, who is having some real dementia issues.
Neighbor Anita, afflicted with dementia. God, keep her close to him and surround her with good help. And sister-in-law Vicki, pray the Lord to give her relief from pain. Jo Ellen.
I thank God that I'm still doing good. My weight's down. And I walk, well, most days I get HB and Walmart. But I walk around inside the house and I do what exercises I can eat.
Thanking God for renewed health, and pray for that to continue with discipline and devotion. Old Passel. Ruth, start us over here. Glenn Holy is still in the hospital. God be with him, strengthen him, and sustain him. Alice, Amy. Faith still in the hospital, hoping for a return home soon. We commend God's little lamb to him for full healing. Sangolo? Is that you? I can't tell with the mask on. Sangolo? Well, that name sounds familiar. I didn't catch the last part.
She gets the citizenship. Olive.
Yeah.
Olive.
Citizenship.
Oh, the citizenship. Yes, yes. We rejoiced in that and continue to thank God. Olive, U.S. citizen. And glad that Songolo returned safely home. Pray the Lord's continued guidance. Bill.
God's blessings on the Ukrainians.
The Chupakovs. Yes. They returned back to Ukraine and asked God to reestablish them there and get them settled for life as it comes in that country. And we have another reason to give thanks today. We have a new member officially coming into our midst. You might have met Diane Rep here before. So we're glad to receive her as into full fellowship at Hope. So Diane, if you'll come forward, we'll make this official. You can just stand there if you like. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Beloved in the Lord, Jesus Christ said to his apostles, "Whoever confesses me before people, I will also confess before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before people, I will also deny before my Father who is in heaven." Lift up your heart, therefore, to the God of all grace, and joyfully give answer to what I now ask you in the name of the Lord. Do you this day in the presence of God and of this congregation acknowledge the gifts that God gave you in your baptism? If so, answer yes, I do. Do you renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways? If so, yes, I do renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, and in the Holy Spirit? Yes, I believe in God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Yes, I believe in God.
Do you hold all the prophetic and apostolic scriptures to be the inspired word of God and the doctrine of the Lutheran Church to be faithful and true? If so, I do. Do you intend to hear the word of God and receive the Lord's Supper faithfully? If so, I do by the grace of God. Do you intend to live according to the Word of God and in faith, word, and deed to remain true to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, even to death? If so, I do by the grace of God. Do you intend to continue steadfast in this confession and church and to suffer all, even death, rather than fall away from it? If so, I do by the grace of God. Do you desire to become a member of this congregation? If so, I do. Will you support the work of our gracious Lord has given this congregation with your prayers and the gifts God has given you? If so, I will with the help of God. Upon this, your confession of faith, I acknowledge publicly that you are a member of the Evangelical Lutheran Church and of Hope Lutheran Church. Participate with us in all the blessings of salvation that our Lord has given to his church in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for your great goodness in bringing this, your daughter, to the knowledge of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and enabling her both with the heart to believe and with the mouth to confess his saving name. Grant that by your word and spirit, she may continue steadfast in the one true faith and the fellowship of this congregation, as together we await the day when all who have fought the good fight of faith shall receive the crown of righteousness through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The right hand of fellowship. Welcome, Diane. We're glad to have you with us. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. Our newest member, Diane. We will sing How Sweet the Name of Jesus Sounds. Stand for confession and absolution. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins unto God our Father, beseeching Him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
O Almighty God, merciful Father, I, a poor miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserved your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them, and I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor sinful being. Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the Word, announce the grace of God unto all of you. And in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
before the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is near. The Lord has established a sacrifice. He has made holy those he has summoned. On the day of the Lord's sacrifice, I will punish the princes, the king's son, and all those wearing foreign clothes. I will punish the one leaping on the threshold on that day, those filling the house of their master with violence and deceit. On that day, says the Lord, an outcry will resound from the fish gate, wailing from the second quarter, a loud crash from the hills. The ones who grind the grain will wail, all the merchants will be silenced. I will eliminate all those weighing out silver. At that time, I will search Jerusalem with lamps. I will punish the men growing fat on the sediment in their wine, those saying to themselves, the Lord will not do good or evil. Their wealth will be looted and their houses destroyed. They will rebuild houses, but not live in them. They will plant vineyards, but not drink the wine. The great day of the Lord is near. It is near and coming very quickly. The sound of the day of the Lord is bitter. A warrior screams there. That day is a day of fury, a day of distress and anxiety, a day of desolation and devastation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and deep darkness, a day for blowing the trumpet and alarm against their invincible cities and against their high towers. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our epistle reading for today is 1 Thessalonians 5, 1-11. We do not need to write to you about the timing and dates, brothers and sisters. You know very well that the day of the Lord is going to come like a thief in the night. When they are saying there is peace and security, at that time sudden destruction will attack them, like labor pains start with a pregnant woman, and they will definitely not escape. But you are not in darkness, brothers and sisters, so the day will not catch you by surprise like a thief. All of you are children of light and children of the day. We do not belong to light, night, or darkness. So then let us not sleep like the others, but let us stay awake and stay sober. People who sleep, sleep at night, and people who get drunk at night. Since we belong to the day, let us stay sober, wearing faithfulness and love as a piece of armor that protects our body, and the hope of salvation as a helmet. God did not intend for us to suffer his wrath, but rather to possess salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus died for us so that whether we are awake or asleep, we will live together with him. So continue encouraging each other and building each other up, just like you were doing already. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your faithfulness has walked beside me.
We stand for the gospel reading. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 25th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus says, "The kingdom of heaven is like a man who was leaving on a trip. He called his servants and handed his possessions over to them. To one he gave 5 valuable coins, and to another he gave 2, and to another he gave 1. He gave to each servant according to that servant's ability. Then he left on his journey. After the man left, the servant who had 5 valuable coins took them and went to work doing business with them. He gained 5 more. In the same way, the one who had 2 valuable coins gained 2 more. But the servant who had received the 1 valuable coin dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. Now, after a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 valuable coins came forward with 5 additional coins. He said, 'Master, you gave me 5 valuable coins. Look, I have gained 5 more.' His master replied, 'Excellent. You are a good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will put you in charge of much. Come, celebrate with me.' Second servant also came forward and said, 'Master, you gave me 2 valuable coins. Look, I have gained 2 more.' His master replied, 'Well done. You are a good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will put you in charge of much. Come, celebrate with me.' Now the one who had received 1 valuable coin came and said, 'Master, I knew that you are a hard man. You harvest grain where you have not sown. You gather crops where you have not spread seed. So I was afraid, and I hid my valuable coin in the ground. Here, you have what is yours.' His master replied, 'You evil and lazy servant. You knew that I harvest grain where I have not sown, and that I gather crops where I have not spread seed. In that case, you should have turned my money over to the bankers, so that when I returned, you could give me what belonged to me with interest. Therefore, take from him the valuable coin and give it to the one who has 10 coins. Those who have much will receive more, and they will have more than they need. But as for those who do not have much, even the little bit they have will be taken away from them. Now take the worthless servant and throw him out into the farthest darkness. People there will be weeping and grinding their teeth.' This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ." We confess the saving faith with the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. You may be seated. We sing the hymn. Thank you. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Sometimes it seems like all is darkness. I don't need to give you specific examples of this. You know what's going on. TV, internet, radio, newspaper. Anywhere you turn, you will find plenty of bad reports. Rape and murder, kidnappings and carjackings, child abuse, degradation of human bodies, crushing of human spirits, corporate owners ruining lives for their own gain, government ruining lives with no accountability, people willing to destroy other people to make a political point. The news is a steady drumbeat of the sick and twisted, those trapped in and possessed by the devil's activity. Sadly, that sometimes describes us and our behavior. We fit right in with the prevailing culture. We get caught up in the raging tide, and we offer no defense in the Spirit of Christ. We hang out in the darkness. We prefer the cover of night. We stay sequestered in secret shame. Then we're easily persuaded by the promise of peace and security. If anyone can guarantee no disruption to my comfort, they've got my vote. If anyone can bring an end to the pandemic nightmare, we'll make him king. All I want is to be secure in my own little corner of the world, not bothered, not threatened, allowed to do as I please. Enticing as it may be right now, that's a dead end. And only fosters a life of temporary thrills and elusive illusions. It leaves you hanging with no higher purpose, no deeper meaning, no enduring influence. And Apostle Paul points out the most troubling aspect. The day of the Lord is coming with suddenness, a compelling conclusion to our time on earth is ahead. Will the Redeemer find you asleep and drunk, meaning out of control, inattentive, and unaware? Do you really want to act like you don't belong to Him? Do you really want to deny your confession of faith by a wayward lifestyle? Here's the truth. We followers of Christ are not in darkness. All the events leading to the day of the Lord don't surprise us. We are not like the others, clueless and distracted. We are attentive to the signs, even as we don't get caught up in them. We let all the events of the day guide us into God's truth. We don't place our hope in worldly systems, political maneuverings, and military might. We are not swayed by false promises and tired assurances. We are not asleep or drunk, lacking awareness of the big picture and the larger meaning, out of our minds in a vain attempt to avoid responsibility. There is no panic in Christians. We know the world is coming to an end now or later. The timing might be a surprise, but the fact of it won't catch us off guard. We are children of the light. We are children of the day. The forces of darkness hold no sway. Why? Because we know Jesus. He said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." We behold the glory of God in the face of Christ. We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father full of grace and truth. We have been baptized into the Savior, the one who gives life, so that we are no longer slaves to sin. Jesus has freed us from the guilt of sin and the power of sin and the shame of sin by His cross and death. By His resurrection, He has brought us to new life and has set us on a new way of life marked by the Spirit. We live in Him and He lives in us in the full light of day. Alert, self-controlled, able to act in His name and showing His righteousness. What do people have to turn to these days? The wise leaders gathered in Washington? A revived economy just around the corner? Another war to exploit our military power? What will get them through the night? More money? Another romantic fling? The next too short and soon forgotten vacation? We have a message of real hope to share about God's plan of redemption, God's provision for His creation, God's secure guidance through coming destruction. We have this message to share every time someone bemoans their circumstances or questions their direction or seeks advice and encouragement. You have personal experience of being brought out of the darkness into the light. Your story of how God brought you into the fullness of His grace. And we have the ability to live lives that shine forth in the darkness. Exactly what the world needs from the followers of Jesus. The most compelling witness we can give now is showing that our actions match our confession, that our hearts and minds and hands are united in the love of our Savior. How do we do that? God's holy word tells us two ways. One, put on the breastplate of faith. Faith that clings to Christ and His work for us, done and done, forgiveness, acceptance, and love by God fully accomplished. Faith that lives by love for our neighbor, recognizing the power and benefit of community, demonstrating joy in selfless service. And two, put on the helmet of salvation. No fear of the wrath of God, since Christ has undertaken it for us. There is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. We are protected and equipped for vigorous battle to stand firm on the front lines as long as it is day. We live in the hope of a glorious eternal tomorrow, not the dread of unknown months and years ahead. God says, I know the plans I have for you, to give you hope and a future. So no more living like children of darkness. No more faithless resignation to the devil's reign. No more anxiety over the unknown, nearby or far away. We are children of the light, and it is time to shine. We have surpassing strength and ultimate security and everlasting peace in the Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which transcends all human understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus unto life everlasting. Amen. We stand for the prayer of the church. Almighty God, everlasting Father, you have made us your people and preserved us through the ministry of your word and sacraments. Continue to pour out upon us grace upon grace, that we may be kept in faith and guarded in hope. Make your church throughout the world one in doctrine, confession, and life, and give to your church faithful pastors who will preach and teach your word with conviction. Deliver us from confusion and error by the power of your Holy Spirit, and raise up those who will continue to serve in faithfulness and humility, that we may be obedient to your word and receive the salvation of our souls. Lord, in your mercy, deliver the nations from oppression and ungodly rulers and governments. Bless all in authority within our own nation, that righteousness may flourish and injustice end. Bless all those places where your people teach and learn, that our children may honor you, walk in your commands, and show forth in their lives the fruits of the Spirit. Lord, in your mercy. Prevent all disaster and calamity. Deliver us from war and violence and spare us from pestilence. Help us to know and rejoice in the good fruits of the earth. Bless all noble occupations and help the arts to flourish, that our lives may be enriched by beauty. Lord, in your mercy. Receive with our song of praise and sacrifice of thanksgiving the tithes and offerings we bring, that through good use of the skills, talents, and time you have given us, you may be glorified in all we are and do. Lord, in your mercy. Give unity to your people, that we may not be divided in doctrine or witness, and grant us grace that we may come to the Lord's table and receive here the body and blood of our Lord Jesus in sincere repentance and faith. Lord, in your mercy. Give to the sick healing, to the suffering relief, to the grieving hope, and to the dying peace. Sustain us in the day of trial. Deliver us from all our enemies of body and soul, and keep us steadfast in the day of trouble. Lord, in your mercy. Remembering that here we have no enduring city, but heaven is our home, Give us your aid so that we may, by true faith and godly life, prepare for the coming of our Savior, doing the works you have called us to do and accomplishing your purpose in our daily lives. Help us to multiply your mercy by loving our neighbor in need and loving you with all our body, soul, strength, and will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. We'll have time to make an offering now in the plate near the entrance to the sanctuary as we hear the piano offertory played by Dr. Garina. We stand for the communion liturgy and the proper preface. It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
thank you.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament shed for the remission of your sins. Do this as often as you drink it to remember me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
stand and give thanks? We give thanks to you, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this reviving gift. And we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Amen.